Last time I reviewed a Red Dragon microphone, I was really disappointed, and I learned that I probably shouldn't spend $30 on audio. But I wanted to give this other microphone a chance because it does look a lot more promising, and it certainly is more promising after testing it out for some time. So with that said, introducing the Red Dragon Blazar. Let's go ahead and dive right in. Before we continue, don't forget that I have a Twitch channel that you can go ahead and follow me on for live microphone reviews and much more than that. But you're also going to find my Twitter, my Instagram, and a link to the Tech Summit Discord in the description. So come join the community because it is a pretty cool one. We've also opened up a Patreon as of late where if you join, you'll be automatically entered to win one tech gadget every month in our exclusive giveaways. Details to that are going to be down below. Don't forget to check out the description for everything. Now let's get right into the video. I'm going to be recording this entire review with this microphone so that you can get a pretty good idea of what it would sound like to use it for content creation. And I'm also going to be streaming with this microphone later tonight at 8 p.m. Eastern time, as in like the same night that this review gets posted, so that you can ask all of your questions live. And the links to my Twitch down in the description. And as always, let's begin with an unboxing. Just go ahead and open up the box by cutting through the label, and then you're going to find some instructions with the Red Dragon sticker. You're also going to be finding the microphone itself, the USB Type-B cable, now the super cheap tripod, the windscreen, and the shock mount. So there are quite a few things in this package. Now, the exterior design of this microphone is really good. This is a hefty microphone with a simple, symmetrical design, red LED ring around it, and a metal volume rocker as well. It is just going to be very simple, but it is just so good for the money, in my opinion. This is a really nicely built microphone. This microphone feels more expensive than what it actually is, especially considering that it comes with so many accessories in the box. The shock mount is also built pretty nicely and feels pretty sturdy. I'm not going to complain so much about that. And the windscreen is actually fine, but the tripod feels extremely cheap and plasticky. I wouldn't use this with this microphone. Invest a little bit more on a mic arm. Like right now, I'm actually using a different microphone stand because I just refuse to use that tripod. And they're very affordable too, like between $10 or $15 usually. However, this is more than just good enough, I would say. This is a really nice build and design for a microphone like this. Now, this is an omnidirectional condenser microphone with a frequency response of 50 Hz to 16 kHz, an impedance of less than 2.2 ohms, and it is addressed from the front like this rather than from the top like I originally thought for some reason. I think it's just because of the symmetrical shape, but oh well. And then let's get into the sound test. This part will be done without any kind of background music or anything like that so that you can hear what this microphone sounds like. It is in a fairly sound-treated room. As you can see, there's like a ton of sound foam everywhere, but I do have this Razer Blade 14 2015 laptop right in front of me with very loud fans that ramp up whenever they feel like it, and this microphone being so close to it obviously doesn't reject that noise very well, but that's for a variety of reasons. One, this is going to be a condenser microphone, so naturally it is just going to be more sensitive to sound. That I don't really have an issue with. Two, however, is that this is an omnidirectional microphone rather than cardioid, which means that this picks up sound at the same potency from the front that it does from the back. So I honestly have no idea why the hell they decided to make this microphone an omnidirectional mic when cardioid simply would have been the best way to go, especially since they market this towards streamers or as like a gaming microphone. You normally want to be able to reject as much sound from other places as possible so that you can be heard very clearly. This means that you do have to put more effort into getting the best sound out of this microphone while accounting for everything else that's in your room. Now, this microphone does sound surprisingly good actually, minus all of the noise that it picks up, and the potential is there for it, no doubt, to be even better. But this is really the type of microphone that I would put a sound like dampening wall behind of to make sure that it doesn't capture anything that it's not supposed to. It is worth noting, however, that up close you really can squeeze quite a bit of quality out of this microphone. Like, I do think that like this, as I have it now, this microphone does sound pretty good. There is just going to be more of a focus now in this case because your voice, or in this case my voice, is just going to be closer to the capsule than what anything else around me would be, so that that's why there is that greater emphasis, and that is also called the proximity effect. It is just going to sound better from up close. And while this microphone does have more of a focus on the high end, it is not a tiny microphone by any means, and I'm pretty sure that the awesome build does contribute to that idea. And now on to my complaints. This is an omnidirectional mic, and I've already talked about why that's a bad choice for it. They also included this tripod, which is honestly quite abysmal in its quality, so I really wouldn't use it. But the microphone with the windscreen and the shock mount are already good enough to justify that price tag, to be honest. I also really do wish that this had a headphone jack for no latency audio monitoring. I really think that that would have been a great feature to include here as well. But I do have to say that I do have a soft spot for this brand in general, and I also really like what they attempted here, though the execution isn't as good as it should have been in this case. This is not good for sound rejection, but this microphone will surprisingly work well with most people's voices, even if it does require a little bit of help to get the most out of it. I probably wouldn't recommend it over the VFine T732, for example, because that's a cardioid microphone. It is still a condenser microphone, but that microphone is still built pretty well, and it still has that gamer aesthetic to it. It comes with a shock mount, already comes with a pop filter, already comes with the microphone arm, and it just costs slightly more, and by slightly more, I mean just about $3 more. But this thing's got this premium feeling gain control buttons on it they are just really nice, and this will exhibit that gamer look that a lot of streamers go for without fail as well. But honestly, I think I would still just recommend going with that kit from VFine, the VFine T732 kit instead for its overall value, and unfortunately, even though I like this microphone, they simply missed the mark here. I can't really recommend this. But if you are still interested in purchasing this microphone, or if, let's say, you did actually want to try to get your hands on the other kit that I recommended from VFine, which would be the T732 kit, then I'll be making sure to leave affiliate links down to both microphones in the description. And there's also going to be Luster, which is going to be a very great tool for like helping you find sales and things of the like, and I very much encourage you to download it, as it's going to be helpful in more than just Amazon and places like that. It is just a very good tool like that. If you've already kind of decided on which microphone you want, you can always go with the Bunda as well, which I'm going to be leaving a link to down in the description as well. Although you can do some very simple and easygoing financing, no credit card required from you at all. It is just going to be very simple to go about it, and it's just going to be an easier way of paying for things over time. So links to that down below. Use any of my links and I'll get a small commission. That does help out the channel quite a bit, so I'd appreciate that quite a bit. And don't forget that I will be streaming with this microphone tonight at 8 p.m. Eastern time, in case you're interested in hearing what it would be like to use this microphone in a non-sound treated room, which is my bedroom, and also just to see what it's like to use this microphone for streaming, to see if maybe you still like it in spite of all of my comments. So links to my Twitch are going to be down below. You can support us on Patreon for monthly giveaways, and you can also support us by other means. Like if you just wanted to follow us on the rest of our social media, there's going to be the Tech Summit Discord, and we're going to have a Twitter and an Instagram as well. So with that said, this has been Francisco from Tech Summit. Thank you for watching, and I will be seeing you all later. Enjoy.